Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thank you. Let me introduce myself. My name is Reno Subekti. I'm from Universitas Negeri Yogyakarta. And now I'm studying in Universitas Gajah Mada. This paper with the title Reverse Optimization and Capital Asset Pricing Model in the Application of the Black Litterman Portfolio. We focus on the application of two types of equilibrium return in Black Litterman portfolio. In the application of the Black Litterman model, we will find the terms of reverse optimization and capital asset pricing model. The two possibilities of equilibrium in the application of Black Litterman model. It is not in the EDOREC papers. However, in many studies, this issue is not much given attention, but we can find the focus on Black Litterman model is from the views of a subjective investor. Therefore, in this study, we want to point out about the both approaches for the Black Litterman model. First, we review both mean variance model and Black Litterman. Mean variance model can be interpreted as the maximize the goal function or the minimize the risk of portfolio in Markowitz model. Yeah. And the solution can be achieved by using Lagrange multiplier. We get the weight, optimal weight in this equation. In equation 2, yeah, we get the output of the weight by using this input mean. And the Black Litterman, the core of the Black Litterman model is we replace this mean in Markowitz with the new target mu BL in equation 3. How to derive the formula of Black Litterman model can be seen in EDOREC, Satchel, Chung, and Walter, and many others about the Black Litterman model. So this is about the new mean as input to get the optimal weight as output. This is the general optimization. But how to get the P, how to get the Q, how to get the components in Black Litterman? In this study, we only focus on the P. P, as mentioned before, there are two types derived from weight market capitalization and from CAPM formula. The type one of P is in equation 4 and the second type in equation 5. In equation 4, this is called as reverse optimization because we know about the weight of capitalization as an input to get the new return. This is the equilibrium return because we use the known market weight capitalization. But from CAPM as prediction return asset, we directly use the P from utilizing the relationship between asset return, risk asset with the market return, considering the free asset, free risk asset. Yeah. So because the literature about the starting point in Black Litterman is rarely found. In Nocera, there is a statement about the weakness of CAPM as a prediction. Meanwhile, by summing that CAPM formula is still used by practitioners, we continue to construct both portfolios. We want to examine the result. For the empirical result, we select 5 assets from LK45 from January 2015 and 2019. This is the calculation of the weight capitalization from price and number of shares and the estimated equilibrium from beta asset. This is the calculation of expected return, black determinant and the weight. And this is the result of expected return portfolio and standard deviation of the return portfolio. From comparison between what P, we notice that the result is very different, but the strong correlation between P1 and P2 is 52.67%. Without any difference for our scalars in black determinant, Q, tau, P, and lambda, we just differ from P, we get the weight for 5 assets. Weight asset from portfolio 1 is from reverse optimization, and weight portfolio 2 is from CAPM. At a glance, we can see that there is a significant difference for Excel, AJPFA, and LPPF. However, we demonstrate that the order of allocation is similar. So, BSDA dominates the first position almost over 50%, then followed by JPFA, LPPF, INCO, and Excel for both portfolios. Consequently, in this case, the weight of black determinant using two approaches can be considered for black determinant model. I think enough. Thank you. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.